This is the unboxing of my Volca sample. I've already unboxed it, but I thought I'd do a little review video. There's a number of review videos about this. I thought I'd do one myself. This is the state the box came in. It seemed, it didn't come open like this, but it did seem like it had been opened already, and there was a bit of a damage to the box there. So I started getting a bit funny about it. I thought maybe somebody had already opened it, and maybe I was getting one that had been returned to the shop, I don't know. But yeah, it's a small box. I mean, initially I thought it might be a little bit larger, but I was surprised by the size of it. Comes in with some packing pieces. This comes in this comes in a sort of polythene bag. This sort of polystyrene type of bag. You get 6 batteries with it as well, and you get this small cable for the syncing option. We'll go in here or out of here. You've got a MIDI in, sync in and out headphones, and it sounds much better with the headphones in, because all it's got on it is a small 1-inch speaker. That's the battery compartment there, which comes off without any problem. Switch it on, and some nice flashing lights there. You've got a bass treble, that shows you there. You can see the low pass, the band pass, and the high pass filter. A sample key, this allows you to, or sample knob, this allows you to change the sound that you're listening to. And this is a little track that I recorded first. When you change the samples, you've got 100 samples. The instruction manual you get 2 manuals. You get this Volca sample thing, which basically just goes through sort of basic treatment, you know, don't damage it or anything, don't leave it out in the handling information and stuff like that, how to care for it or whatever. This is the actual instruction manual. There's not a lot on it. I think you have to have some understanding of samples before you start mucking about with them. Oh, there's not a great deal here. This can be downloaded free of charge anyway off of the korg website. It goes through the individual buttons and different functions that they have. But otherwise it doesn't go through a great deal of making up tracks or how to sort of add layers to tracks as such. There's a lot of videos on the internet, or there's a few videos on YouTube that explain that sort of thing. And yeah, that's about it for now. Thanks very much.